إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار Brothers and sisters in Islam, قال الله تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى said لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب Indeed, in the stories that are mentioned in the Quran, there is a lesson always for the people who have understanding. But the people who lack the understanding, they will normally look at the stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in a way of amusement or entertainment. And one of the stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in his book في سورة القلم قصة أصحاب الجنة the story of the people or the companions of the garden قال الله تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى said إنا بلوناهم كما بلونا أصحاب الجنة إذ أقسموا ليصرمنها مصبحين Indeed, we have tested the people of Quraysh, like we have tested the companions of the garden when they took oath that in the morning, very early in the morning, they will go and harvest the fruit of this garden. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ They said tomorrow in the morning, they will harvest the fruit of this garden. And they did not say, Insha'Allah. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ Meaning, they did not say, Insha'Allah. فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ At night, when they were asleep, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a storm that turned that garden that is about to be harvested into pitches of darkness. فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالصَّرِيمِ Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do that to them? Because they intended, once they went to sleep, they intended that they will not give the masakeen anything from the fruits or the harvest of this garden. فَتَنَادَوْ مُصْبِحِينَ In the morning, once they waked up, they called one another, أَنِغْدُوا عَلَىٰ حَرْثِكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَارِمِينَ Let's go and harvest our garden. وَغَدَوْا عَلَىٰ حَرْدٍ قَادِرِينَ And they had that determination, أَلَّا يَدْخُلَنَّهَا الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِسْكِينَ Make sure that no miskeen will enter your garden today. Let us even go early in the morning so that they do not see us harvesting. What is the story? Those are, in some of the wording, three sons, some other wordings, five sons. Their father used to be a very righteous man. كان له جنة فيحاء. He used to have a beautiful garden where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses him with a lot of harvest. But this man had a habit. قيل أنه كان يعطي شطر المحصول للفقراء والمساكين. He used to divide the harvest into half. One half to the masakin and one half to the family and reinvestment in it. وقيل third. And it was said third of the harvest to the masakin. Of course his children did not like that. His children did not like the fact that he is taking out all of this and giving it to the poor and to the masakin. And they were really upset and angry about it. But while the father was alive, they could not do anything. The first year after the death of the father, they planned not to even give the right of the poor, which is the zakah, from the harvest. That's their intention. They slept at night with this intention. Because of that intention, yet they did not harvest yet. But they slept with that intention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a storm that basically stripped the fruits out. فَتَنَادَوْ مُصْبَحِينَ. In the morning they are calling one another. أَنِغْدُوا عَلَىٰ حَرْثِكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَارِمِينَ فَانْطَلَقُوا وَهُمْ يَتَخَافَتُونَ. And they left in secret. Let's go, let's go. So the masakin do not know. Let's go. أَلَّا يَدْخُلَنَّهَا الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِسْكِينَ. No miskin shall enter your garden today. وَانْطَلَقُوا وَغَدَوْا عَلَىٰ حَرْدٍ قَادِرِينَ. Here is the surprise. فَلَمَّا رَأَوْهَا قَالُوا إِنَّا لَضَالُّونَ. They looked at the garden that they left yesterday. Nothing. They said, we must have got lost. This is not our garden. قَالُوا بَلْ نَحْنُ مَحْرُومُونَ. No. We are deprived because of that intention. Those companions of the garden, يقول أهل العلم, the people of knowledge, they say, they are guilty of two crimes. جريمتين. Number one, الاستثناء. المثنوية. What is المثنوية? That you say, Insha'Allah. يعني they said, tomorrow, in the morning, early, we will go and harvest the garden. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ, it means they did not say inshallah. وَالْإِسْتِثْنَاءِ فِي دِينِنَا فَرْض is actually mandatory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, وَلَا تَقُولَنَّ لِشَيْءٍ إِنِّي فَاعِلٌ ذَلِكَ غَدَىٰ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ. Don't say to something that you will do tomorrow without insha'Allah. Because you do not have tomorrow. أنت لا تملك غدا. غدا هذا لا تملكه. You don't know if you're going to live. You don't know if what you're trying to do is going to be available to do. And يعني حتى من باب الأدب, even from the avenue of being polite مع رب العالمين, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قدر لنا أمورا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed things upon us in the preserved tablet, في اللوح المحفوظ. من باب الأدب مع قدر الله, قل إن شاء الله. يعني to be polite, say إن شاء الله. Yani, subhanAllah, once we fly, and then the pilot starts, you know, sharing with you the plan. and we're going to be cruising over this, and then we're going to land in 4 hours. Wallahi ya akhi, once he says this, حينما يقول هذه ينبض القلب. يا راجل قول إن شاء الله. Say إن شاء الله يا شيخ. حتى هذه إن شاء الله benefits the corrupt people. لعلكم يعني تعرفون قصة يأجوج ومأجوج. في قصة في القرآن ذكرت في سورة الكهف, يأجوج and مأجوج. People who corrupt earth. And the solution was for Dhul Qarnayn basically to block them, blockade. Said that they do not come out. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما أخرج ابن ماجة وأحمد والترمذي وصححه الحاكم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, يقول لك every single day يأجوج and مأجوج. As we speak now, those two tribes, they exist, أخي. They do exist. These satellites, huh? Does not see them, but they exist somewhere behind a wall. Every single day, they go and dig that wall. ينقبون. Until, حتى أنهم يكادون أن يروا ضوء الشمس. يعني about to see the sunlight, the rays of the sun coming through the wall. And then they say, we are getting tired. Let's come back tomorrow. Let's go back tomorrow and do it. And they do not say, Insha'Allah. They will come back tomorrow. They find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making that wall stronger than the way that they left it. That hole is filled. Until Allah decrees. حتى يقدر الله, وهذا سيحدث في المستقبل من علامات الساعة هذه الكبرى. One of the major signs of the day of resurrection, when Isa عليه السلام descends as a Muslim, a follower of Islam, he will pray behind the Imam of the Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decree for those two tribes to break through that wall. Look how. When Allah decrees, Allah will inspire that leader to say, their leader to say, let's come back tomorrow, insha'Allah. يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم واستثنى. Then they will come back tomorrow. They will find the wall the way that they left it. They will finish up digging and they will break through. الشاهد الاستثناء حتى مع غير المسلم, يعني مع غير سي إن شاء الله. حتى في الطاعات, the Muslims these days, it's very sad, they use it as a justification for not fulfilling their covenants. إلا خلاص إن شاء الله, إن شاء الله. يعني أنت قلت إن شاء الله خلاص. يعني هذا الرجل ذهب إلى السوق, يقال له جحا, يعني he went to the market. Where are you going يا جحا؟ He said, I want to buy a donkey. فقالوا له قل إن شاء الله. تبقوا say إن شاء الله. قال why? The market is there and the wallet is in, the money is in my pocket. فذهب إلى السوق. He went to the market. Somebody as soon as he stepped there stole his wallet. He came back. What happened يا جحا? How come you did not buy a donkey? He said, سرقت محفظتي إن شاء الله. My wallet was stolen إن شاء الله. هكذا هذا المسلم. أنتم تضحكون يا جماعة, you laugh about this, but this is how Muslims now look at inshallah. This is how they treat inshallah. But inshallah, if you say it, is the caliber of iman akhi, is a caliber. It actually refers to a person who holds a good creed. يعني لما جاء إبراهيم, when Ibrahim عليه السلام came to his son Ismail, وقال له يا بني, my son, إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك. فانظر ماذا ترى. My son, I see in my dream that I am to slaughter you. What do you say? قال يا أبا تفعل ما تؤمر. My father, وفق هذا الغلام, وفق. My father, do what you're commanded. ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. You will find me, insha'Allah. Because لا تدري. الإنسان يقول لك sometimes I'm gonna go and I'm gonna do this and I'm gonna do this. Especially once it comes, فينفسخ عزم القلب. لأن هذا القلب everything is in the heart and the heart in the hand of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. إن قلوب بني آدم بين أصبعين من أصابع الرحمن يقلبها كيف يشاء. فالاستثناء المسلم ها يعني the companions of the garden they said what لنصرمنها مصبحين ولا يستثنون. هذه الجريمة الأولى. الجريمة الثانية الشح stinginess البخل. يعني they seen their father giving half or third of the harvest. They didn't like that. They wanted to withhold. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما ورد في سنن أبي داود من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما يسيس إياكم والشح. إياكم والشح. Be careful from stinginess. فإنما هلك من كان قبلكم بالشح. The nations before you, they were destroyed because of stinginess. أمرهم بالبخل فبخلوا وأمرهم بالقطيعة فقطعوا وأمرهم بالفجور ففجروا. شح. Being stingy. والإنسان الشحيح والله للأمانة يعني a person who is stingy أجهل خلق الأرض. أجهل خلق الله في الأرض. The most ignorant of people in earth. لأنه لا يعي. He doesn't know that Allah سبحانه وتعالى blessed you with money and you withhold and you keep it, not even giving the zakah, not even giving the right of the poor in your money. He also have no yaqeen. No yaqeen. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم once he talked about the sadaqah في حديث أبي مالك الأشعري والصدقة برهان. الصدقه is an evidence that you believe. The fact you dig your hand in your pocket and you take the most beloved thing to you, money, and you give it out, and your reward in the next life is a sign that you believe. That is why as-sadaqah is an evidence that you believe. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, مخاطباً, speaking to the stingy people, ولا يحسبن الذين يبخلون بما آتاهم الله من فضله هو خيرا لهم. Let those who are stingy and withholding the things that Allah bestowed upon them in the first place is good for them. بل هو شر لهم. It's evil for them. Look, سيطوقون ما بخلوا به يوم القيامة. In the day of resurrection, the things that they withhold will encircle them. Look how the Sunnah explains this and the beauty of the Quran and the Sunnah. في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول ما من صاحب مال ولا ذهب ولا فضة لا يؤدي حق الله فيه. An owner of money, cash, gold, silver, does not give the right of Allah in it. In the day of resurrection, his money will turn into ثعبان له ذبيبتان. A snake that has two horns and will chase him for 50,000 years, running after him. That's how long the day of resurrection is. Someone says, Sheikh, 50,000, what do you mean? Akhi, we're gonna, this body will be refashioned and it will encircle the person and it will bite him in the cheek and it will tell him, أنا كنزك أنا مالك. I'm your wealth, I'm your treasure. والذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقونها في سبيل الله فبشرهم بعذاب أليم. And those who accumulate gold and silver, they go and place the money in the bank and all the pleasure that they get is the bank statement. ما شاء الله, it's 20,000. ما شاء الله, 25,000.
يمكن يكون معيش أهله أهله في ذل. And he may, his family does not even food. Save the money, save the money, save the money. And they do not spend it in the cause of Allah. فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. Give them, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the evil tiding. وهذا من سبيل السخرية. Evil tiding. What?
يَوْمَ يُحْمَى عَلَيْهَا فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ فَتُكْوَى بِهَا جِبَاهُهُمْ وَجُنُوبُهُمْ وَظُهُورُهُمْ هَذَا مَا كَنَزْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ فَذُوقُوا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْنِزُونَ.
It will turn, the gold and silver will turn into blades, and it will be heated in the hellfire, and they will be branded by it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains this as well في صحيح مسلم حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من صاحب ذهب ولا فضة. A person who owns gold and silver, لا يؤدي حق الله فيها, he does not give the right of Allah in it, إلا صفحت له يوم القيامة صفائح من نار. The gold and the silver will turn into blades from fire, and it will be heated in the hellfire. We know that وجيء يوم إذن بجهنم, the hellfire will be brought into the place of gathering. And that gold and silver will turn into blades, and it will be heated in the hellfire. فَيُكْوَى بِهَا جَنْبُ فَيُكْوَى بِهَا وَجْهُهُ وَجَنْبُهُ وَظَهْرُهُ. Look at this. كُلَّمَا بَرَدَتْ أُعِيدَتْ. His face will be branded white, his sides, his back, and every time that the heat will cool down, it will be heated again. في يوم كان مقداره 50,000 سنة. For how long? Oh, 50,000 years. حتى يقضي الله بين العباد ويعرف مصيره إلى الجنة أو إلى النار. Until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pronounces the final judgment, and he would then know if he's going to Jannah or to hellfire. The companions ask him, وماذا عن الإبل يا رسول الله? What's happened to the, if you own camels, O Messenger of Allah. أما صاحب الإبل, a person who owns camels, لا يؤدي حق الله فيها, and he does not give the right of Allah in it. Look at this. In the day of resurrection, يسطح بها بقاء قرقر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn earth into a softy, sandy earth. And these camels will tumble on the top of this person, because he did not give the right. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, وَمَاذَا عَنِ الْغَنَمِ وَالْبَقَرِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ? What about sheep and cows? The same thing. وَمَاذَا عَنِ الْخَيْلِ? The same thing. فالإنسان, a person who is stingy with his money, he does not even give the right. And this is what happened to the companions of the garden. They refused to give. Akhi, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given you $1,000, 2.5% of that money is not yours. You have to treat it this way. It's not yours. It is not yours. What you actually own is 975. 250 are not yours. They are the right of the poor. Allah placed it in your hand. المسلمون الآن يا جماعة, زي يقول لك إيه, the most neglected pillar in Islam is الزكاة. يعني you find systems, taxes. You would go to jail if you do not pay taxes. ولا حد يقول لك أنت ما دفعت الزكاة. If you don't pay taxes in the back in the wilderness, in a Muslim, over here at least they have an excuse. But over there, the so-called, they don't even care about it. They don't even care about it. When Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, radiyallahu an Abi Bakr al-Siddiq, began his leadership dealing with an issue like this. وَاللَّهِ لَوْ مَنَعُونِ عِقَالَ بَعِيرٍ كَانُوا يُؤَدُّونَهُ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ لَقَاتَلْتُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ. تلاقي المسلم الآن ها ولا يحسب الزكاة. He does not even calculate the zakah. Does not even. He would calculate everything by the book. By the cent. You owe me 5 cents, brother. But when Allah, he takes $10, okay, throw it in the box, zakat. And he does nothing. After his intention was sadaqah. Okay, you know what? I'm going to change my intention now and make it zakah. لا ينفع. إنما الأعمال بالنيات. If you're giving it for sadaqah, and the difference between the two, the zakah is 2.5%. يعني هذا اللفظ إذا أطلق, when you say zakah, it could mean sadaqah at the same time. But if you say zakah and sadaqah في تخصيص, الزكاه is the 2.5%. الصدقة is more. He goes and throws maybe $10 here, $50 here, and when he's, did you pay your zakah? Huh? He gave it as with the intention of sadaqah. Then he would say, you know what? I gave him 10, لا ينفع. لازم the intention, هذا زكاة المال. هذا زكاة المال. The other issue where really the person who's stingy is, does not understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أخي, in the Quran tells you, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ. يعني سبحان الله, if I come to you right now and I tell you, I'm not a stockbroker, but for the sake, I have these stocks, you're going to buy it for $10, in 4 years the stock is going to be $100, wallahi you're not going to stop people from buying. You're not. هنا رب العالمين يقول مثل الذين ينفقون في سبيل أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف. The likeness of those who give their money to Allah in charity to Allah is like a seed that grows 7 grains in each 7 grains in each 7 ears of grains in each ear, there is 100. That means 700. This is how much kickback you're getting. Even in this country, ya akhi, they take some 15% of. You have to give it, okay? I'm not saying you don't have to give it. You have to give it. This is the law here. We obey the law here. But it tells you you're going to get it back on the age of 65. But give me a break. Rasul Sallallahu told me, أعمار أمتي بين الستين والسبعين. The overwhelming majority of my ummah will not pass 70. So, 5 years? Maybe you can plead it. Can we receive that at the age of 40 or something? And we give it. Ya akhi, yawm al-qiyamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَقْبَلُ الصَّدَقَةَ مِنْ أَحَدِكُمْ بِيَمِينِهِ ثُمَّ يُرَبِّيهَا لَهُ كَمَا يُرَبِّي أَحَدُكُمْ فَلُوَّهِ. Allah will take the sadaqah from you with his right hand. وَكِلْتَ يَدَيْهِ يَمِينَ. And both of his hands are right. Don't try to visualize them. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. لَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفْوًا أَحَدٌ. And he will grow it for you like you bring up your little horse, baby horse. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you in the Quran, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ. When you spend, Allah will replace it for you. حتى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما ثبت في سنن الترمذي من حديث أبي كبش الأنماري رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم 3 أقسم عليهن. 3 things I'm willing to take an oath on. 1. ما نقص مال من صدقة. Your money will not decrease because of a sadaqah that you give. If you give $1,000, Allah will replace the $1,000 for you. You will see it in this world. يعني هذه القصة, this story that is Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim compiled من حديث أبي هريرة. ومن أهل العلم, by the way, some of the people of knowledge said that this man about which the story is addressing, is talking, is هو the father of those children. The father who was generous with his money. Here is a story. أَنَّ رَجُلًا كَانَ يَسِيرُ فِي أَرْضٍ فَلَا. A man was walking in the desert. فَرَأَ سَحَابًا. He saw a cloud. And then he heard, فَسَمِعَ صَوْتًا يَقُولُ لِهَذِهِ السَّحَابَةِ اسْقِي أَرْضَ فُلَانٍ. He heard a voice commanding the cloud to go and rain in a certain place to water the garden of so and so. Don't be surprised, this story happened in Bani Israel. Bani Israel, ajayb, wonders. They had wonders. The man followed the cloud. Tab'al, mishi wara as-sahaba. At one stage, as-sahaba wakfitu, started raining. Not even that, the rain went into a water stream, a canal. Ganaya kida saghira. He followed it. And he found a man having some tool in his hand, trying to let the water go. He said, "Assalamu alaykum." And he used the name that he heard earlier, so and so. Sallam alayhi bil ism. For the man told him, "Ya hada kayfa arafta ismi? How did you know my name?" Qala wallahi, by Allah, I heard a voice commanding that cloud that just rained the water that you have to come and water your garden. أخبرني ماذا تفعل. Tell me what do you do. قال والله لا أفعل كثيرا ولا قليلا. I don't do whole a lot. إلا أنني accept, I divide the harvest, أقسم محصول إلى ثلاثة أقسام. Three portions, three thirds. One third for me and my family. ثلث لأهلي. The second third, I reinvest it in the land. أعيده في باطن الأرض. And the third third, I give it in charity. أعطيه للفقراء والمساكين. طب, can you imagine? This third maintained, sustained his garden. His garden is in the desert. And we talk about Shaitan. Shaitan comes to you sometimes and make you fear when you're about to spend. And imagine this. Sometimes you have $100 in your pocket and you want to give sadaqah. Okay, I'm going to give the $100. The bills, the children, 50. What about the future? You don't know. 25. All what you're going to get out maybe is a dollar if you're successful. In nafs with shaitan. النفس, by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ لَوْ أَنْتُمْ تَمْلِكُونَ خَزَائِنَ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّي إِذَا لَأَمْسَكْتُمْ خَشْيَةَ الْإِنْفَاقِ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ قَتُورًا. النفس by creation is stingy. والشيطان يأتي, الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء. Some of the things that it tells you, that how do you know that this person is going to use the money properly? I'm delivering this khutbah. It's not a fundraising or the haja. But the ikhwa in Boulder, Ghadan, inshallah, our brothers in Boulder, they really need our help and support. So this is the spirit of my khutbah to you today. They have a fundraising tomorrow, inshallah, in the Marriott's around here. Help them out. Plan to help them out. Shaitan may come to you and say, how do you know the brothers are going to use the money properly? How do you know? Ya akhi, it's not your business. It's not your business. Make sure, as you give it, your intention is for Allah. I'll leave it. We have a hadith. A man from Bani Israel also. He said, tonight I will give a sadaqah in secret. Tonight I'm going to give a sadaqah in secret to Allah. والحديث في صحيح مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة. He took his money. It was very dark. And he placed it in the hand of somebody that he did not even know. The whole town in the morning said, تصدق الليلة أعزكم الله على زانية. Last night, a prostitute received the sadaqah. The man became so depressed. Here I am wanting to give sadaqah for Allah and I end up giving أعزكم الله على زانية. He said, I'm going to try tonight again. He placed the money, his sadaqah, in the hand of somebody that he did not know. In the morning, the people started saying, last night, تصدق الليلة على سارق. A thief, somebody who steals. Man, it's not working at all. I'm going to try once more.
تصدق الليلة على غني. The richest man in the city received the sadaqah last night. He given up. He said, I'm done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to him an angel. And again, this happened in Bani Israel. Do not expect angels, huh? In Bani Israel. This is in the angels. قال له يا هذا أو سو أن سو والله لقد قبل الله صدقتك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted your sadaqah and it went into the hands of the right people. أما عن الزانية, the woman who used to do adultery, she was doing this to make a living. And your sadaqah sufficed her. Now she has repented because of your sadaqah. السارق, the thief, the same thing. الغني, he was stingy. And when he saw you giving a sadaqah in that fashion at night, now he's encouraged and he will share his wealth. أنت لا تدري. You don't know. He says sometimes they say, الشيطان يقول لك, how do you know they're going to use the money properly? Be smart. Give it to the right people. And the right people will never come. Will never come. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما جاءه الأعرابي, when a Bedouin came to him, قال يا رسول الله, when is the best time to give sadaqah? When? قال أن تصدق وأنت صحيح شحيح تخشى الفقر وتأمل الغنى. You give sadaqah when you're healthy. Why when you're healthy? Because you're always planning Hawaii trip, Florida, Disney. Give sadaqah now, صحيح. You have a lot of plans. شحيح, when you stingy, when you like the money, when you like to withhold. تخشى الفقر, and you're afraid to be poor, and you want them to be rich. طب والله, tell me if these conditions does not apply to each one of us. ولا تنتظر, and don't wait until the soul reaches the throat, and then you start, okay, let me give this, and he's dying, huh? Leaving the, let me give, وكان, they will get it whether you like it or not. لا, صحيح, when you're healthy, انت حتموت اصلا, they're going to take it, they're going to take it from you. The companions of the garden, they were not wise, because they decided not to give the poor and the masakin the right in the garden of their fathers. And this is what happened to them. And this is the lesson that we learn from that beautiful story that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Qalam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل, وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله, صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, help out our brothers tomorrow, inshallah. Don't belittle your contributions. Don't. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما ورد هذا الحديث في الصحيح وغيره بروايات مختلفة, different wording, من بنى لله مسجدا ولو كمفحص قطاه بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة. Listen to this carefully. If you build a house for Allah, even if the size of this house is a bird nest. The scholars, by the way, looked into this. Can you brain a bird nest? Impossible. Bird nest, we're talking. You cannot even do ruku or sujood. If you contribute to the building of a house for Allah, the amount of a bird nest, Allah will build for you a house in paradise. هذا ما وصل إليه أهل العلم. If you have $10, a bird nest. Don't belittle your contribution. Don't. And these are, you know, especially building masjids in America, is you're constructing a house for Allah. And I would imagine my brothers whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed and guided to build this building, I would not imagine that they thought that we're going to have two Jum'ahs, and that we're having problems with the sheriffs and with the regarding the parking, and now we have to think about expansion somewhere else. فأنت الآن يعني سبحان الله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you that opportunity that maybe after you leave this world 30, 40, 50 years, Allah will bless it because of your intention. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما ورد في صحيح مسلم من حديث أنس بن مالك حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه إذا مات الإنسان أو ابن آدم روايتان انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. When you die, your good deeds خلاص بح, no more. One of them is صدقة جارية, incurring صدقة that keeps giving you. Be intelligent, be smart, seize the opportunity, brothers and sisters in Islam, and contribute to our to the masjid in Boulder, inshallah, tomorrow. Even by your presence, inshallah. And this is the spirit of a community. We should be a community. Even so, they are in Boulder, but they are our community. We are the same community. We are Muslims. We are Muslims. We are all Muslims. We should stand for the welfare of the ummah, wherever it is. So I urge my brothers, and I call upon all of you, inshallah, tomorrow I will not have a lecture because I would like to be myself present there and just, you know, participate in the function and help my brothers, inshallah. And we make dua for them, at least that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them success so they can buy this land, so a house for Allah can be established in Boulder, inshallah. Allahumma ghafir lana dunubana wa israfana fi amrina وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. قولوا قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم, وأقم الصلاة.